If you haven't done it yet, get your phone out right now, open your text messages, and the body of the text, type the name Jesus, and then send it to the number 27126. Don't forget to do that. Text the name Jesus and the body of the text, send it to the number 27126. Hey, has it been a good night? Can we celebrate everything that God has done already tonight?
Oh, yeah.
Now, Winterjam, I need you to get on your feet. Because guess what? It ain't over! We still got some more to go! How many of you here tonight are ready for Skillet? Are you ready for Skillet?
can be unstoppable, gonna be indestructible. You're the one that can save me. Now I'm taking it back, it was never yours. Fighting for my focus, damn the pain of purpose. Light the fire inside, feel it come alive. Show up what you made, victories for the brave. Who never bow to me, when it's do or die. One more time, survive in the cave. We'll be right back. Yeah.
Winter Jam! How you feeling up in here tonight? That's not bad at all. I said, how you feeling up in here tonight? Oh, I should have known, because Peoria rocks. I should have known. Man, we got a bunch of people out here tonight ready to lose your voices. I love it. Thank you so much for coming tonight to Winter Jam. What a privilege it is to be back playing live music. I love it. Thank you, my brother. I got to meet all these lovely people over here earlier tonight. 5 years clean and sober. 5 years clean and sober. I love to celebrate people like this, because whenever we celebrate that, you know, we're actually bragging on Jesus Christ, who died that we may be set free from the power of sin and addiction. I love to brag on Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And tonight I'm excited about that, because you see, 2022, this has been a strange couple of years. I don't know if you know that. See, a lot of people think 22 is going to be a year of pain and destruction, despair. But I gotta tell you what I believe. Nobody knows the future, but what I believe is this. 2022 is going to be a year of incredible blessing and victory for the people of God. Because the world is making all of their decisions through fear. Yep. But if you know Jesus Christ, the Bible says you don't have a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. You know that. So I don't know what's going to happen in the world this year, but what I know is this. Whatever comes, the people of God are going to be victorious. That's what I believe with all my heart. Some people have said, John, I don't think you understand the times we're living in. I don't think you understand that there are Christians right now in this country who are being censored because of their beliefs in Jesus Christ. I know, that's true. Some say, John, I don't know if you understand. There are people today in America losing their jobs because of their faith in Jesus Christ. I know that too.
Yep.
John, you don't understand. We might not be that far away from seeing people imprisoned because of their faith in Jesus Christ. That may be true too. We don't know, do we? I don't think that's going to happen. Because I don't think the people of God are going to let it happen. But I want to tell you this. It's true. We're not that far away. It could happen. So John, what do you mean it's going to be a year of victory? What happens if they start sending Christians to prison for our faith in Jesus Christ? I will tell you what I believe will happen is that the prisons in this country will be so full and overflowing because so many people will not bow their knee to the world. So many Christians will not deny Jesus Christ as Lord. So I'll tell you what's going to happen if that happens. These prisons will be overflowing with the power of God and the Word of God, so overflowing that it just might be like Acts, the book of Acts. Prison guards giving their lives to Jesus because they don't understand how these people could possibly have joy in the midst of this. I'll tell you why they'll have joy in the midst of this, because you cannot stop the Word of the living God. You can't stop that. The Bible says righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Spirit is the kingdom of God. No government can stand against the kingdom of God. No president can stand against the kingdom of God.
That's so
no nation can stand against the kingdom of God. Big media can't stand against the kingdom of God. Hollywood celebrities can't stand against the kingdom of God. In the book of Psalms, it says it like this: oh God, show the nations they are but men. We have a record that just came out 2 weeks ago. It is called Dominion.
Yeah.
We called it Dominion because I think that the world, not just the world, but some Christians as well, and I'm not being mean to any of those people who are here, I love you, I got tons of love for you. The world has forgotten who owns this place up in here. A lot of Christians have forgotten who owns this place, and it is not the devil, and it is not the powers of darkness, and it ain't some sort of virus. Jesus Christ is Lord over the earth. He is ruling over the earth as we speak right now. This is his dominion. Woo! We're going to play this worship song for you. Because no matter what may come in 2022, we know that we stand on an everlasting, unshakable foundation in Jesus Christ.
You are my angel. on some heels.
I told you we had a brand new record out. Came out 2 weeks ago. I know not everybody collects physical CDs anymore, but tonight right here in Peoria is one of the only places in the entire world you can actually pick up the new CD. It is on sale for $10, you can get it at the table, or for $20, you can get my book and the CD, basically, at the same cost. So, we're gonna play something brand new, would that be all right? This song's called Dominion, but I need to see some people getting a little bit crazy on this song. Up. You know what I think's happening? I think The world is getting so absolutely insane that this is going to be an incredible year for people who want to find out what life is all about. People are looking for answers. These young people are being raised in the most psychotic time I have ever seen.
Very true.
All you young people here, how many people of you young people, how do you think this world has lost its mind? Listen up. All you young folks, listen up. You are being lied to every single day.
That's right, that's right.
It's true, isn't it? You open up social media, you're being lied to. You watch any news, you're definitely being lied to. You listen to politicians, you're being lied to. Hollywood is lying to you. Influencers are lying to you. Your teachers are probably lying to you.
I hope he says, let's go, Brandon.
And that's not even all. Guess what? There's a lot of people who used to be Christians who are also lying to you. You see them online, don't you? They used to be Christians. Sometimes they used to be pastors, teachers, preachers, Christian musicians. And they get online and they tell you, this is why I left the faith, and this is the reason you should leave the faith too. They are telling you, this is what you have to do. You have to find true happiness in your heart. That's the only reason you're alive, and the only way to find true happiness is to divorce yourself from Jesus Christ. The only way to find happiness is to divorce yourself from the Bible. Now, some of these deconstructed Christians, they think they found a third way. They will tell our young people, you don't have to divorce yourself from Jesus, just divorce yourself from the Bible. And I'm here to tell you tonight, there is no such thing as loving Jesus but not loving His Word. There is no such thing. There is no such thing as saying, I really am in Jesus, I just don't believe the Bible. You are being lied to, and they are ripping you off. And here's what I want to know. For all of these celebrities telling you how to find happiness, I don't have to put up that good of an argument against these people. All I got to say is this. If Hollywood is so happy, I want to know why their lives are so screwed up.
Yep.
If they are so happy, I want to know why they are committing suicide in the largest, highest rates in American history. I want to know why they're so depressed. I want to know why they are so anxiety-ridden. I want to know why they change sexual partners every single week and then enter into depression. They think they are finding freedom by liberating themselves from God. And I feel bad for them, because they don't even know that they are slaves. That's right. They don't even know they're slaves. There is no such thing as freedom outside of Jesus Christ. There is no such thing as freedom outside of Jesus Christ. It just doesn't happen. They don't even know they are slaves. I'll tell you what I'm excited about. I'm excited because this has been such a crazy time. Lots and lots of young people are starting to say, maybe this isn't working. Maybe there is an answer that I can build my life upon. Yes, there is an answer. His name is Jesus Christ. That is why He came and died for you. I'm excited because there's a generation of young people asking the right questions. And it's time for you young folks to tell all these social media people and influencers, it's time to tell them, we are not listening anymore.
That's right.
We are not listening anymore. I'm excited about seeing a generation rise up to be passionate for Jesus. My wife's going to hand me this book over here. Thank you. I wrote this book. It's called Awaken Alive to Truth. I just want to tell you about it very quickly before we play more music. I wrote this book so that young people can understand the fundamental truths of the Bible. This book is sold at the Billy Graham Library. It is sold to Focus on the Family, and I'm saying that because leaders, parents, I want you to know you're not getting anything strange here, okay? This is fundamental Bible theology in a way that young people can understand why they need Jesus in the first place. Because society is lying to them. Society is telling all of our young people, you're good just the way you are. But the Bible says, actually, there's a big problem with the way that you are. Because every single one of us has sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. You are not okay, but Jesus made a way for you to be restored. That's the great news. So this is on sale. You can get it with the CD for $20. I just wanted you to know that. Do you guys have this? No, you can have it. I signed it for you. Yeah, that's yours. I want to see a generation of Christians not ashamed to call Jesus Lord. A generation of Christians not afraid to call Him Savior. A generation of Christians not afraid to call Him Hero. Question. Do you feel like a monster? Yeah.
gotta let you see. I keep it caged, but I can't control it. So stay away from me, the pieces out of me. I feel enraged and I just can't hold it. It's such a long road, and the balls in my balls. It comes with where you can't get control it. Hiding under the bed, in my body, in my head. Why won't somebody come save me from this? Make it in a truck. Shadows could be making history. To the fire.